Yeah, go.
Here, try out, man. Come on. Yeah, go. So, let's talk about the straw man. Is it a theory? As you come in a room, give a thumbs up, and more importantly, tender donation. It would be greatly appreciated. And to those of you on TikTok, man, share it. Like it and share it. Ties of Doc is in your midst. Let's talk about the straw man thing. Cynthia donated for an SPC packet today. That was a good look on her behalf. Deauthorized representative is in the building. Shout out to him, man.
Shalom, D.
Seth is in the building, man, eating Panda Express, man. Hopefully he'll survive that encounter.
Shalom, Seth.
So, we're all created by Yahuwah in a sovereign capacity. We can find that in the book of Bereshit. Some of you might refer to it as Genesis. See, the Creator, the Most High, has authority and control over all creation. So, although you're one of the sons of my voice, I need you to hear me well. At birth, we're only subject to the Most High. We're only subject to Yahuwah. Our status is that of a free man and womb man. That's a phrase worth repeating. Our status at birth is that of a free man. And we know a baby is not a man, but I'm speaking in common parlance. And a free womb man. That's our status at birth. Now, previous free men and women created what is known as government. What you guys call the government today is actually essentially a de facto. Existed in fact, but not officially established. You call it government. But the free man and the free womb man created government, so we have authority and control over everything that we create. So that means we have authority and control over the government. Now, you can like that, understand it, believe it or not. And I damn sure don't look like Ripley. And that's not my name. And so the Most High has authority and control over us. But we have authority and control over the government. The government created corporations over which the government has authority and control. Now, if you allow the government to reduce you to a corporation, then it has control over you. See, the government incorporated itself, brothers and sisters. Then they incorporated us. Why? So they could actually interface and have control over us. And this is what the entire straw man concept consists of. I know you don't believe it. You said, nah, Todd the Doc, I'm hearing this story, but now you're hearing it from the right one. I'm telling you, the United States is a municipal corporation. As is every state. Have a look at 28 USC subsection. 3002 subsection 15A. Have a look at that. It's a corporation. And they made you a corporation. It's a municipal corporation. The state that you're in is a franchisee of the government of Washington, D.C. The towns, the counties, the village, they all have become municipal entities. The United States, which is, again, a municipal corporation, it only has exclusive jurisdiction over the 10 square miles of the District of Columbia. Also, the territories of Guam, Puerto Rico. A lot of you people say, I'm Boricua. But you can't be a corporation. You can't be a secure party creditor if you're there. Because if you're from there, they own you. This is why we noticed that Secretary of Treasury. If you are a citizen of Washington, D.C., Guam, or Puerto Rico, or any of those provinces, they own you. I know you don't like the way that sounds, but it's true. And all military installations, such as shipyards, military bases, federal courthouses, U.S. post offices. And by adoption and under the uniform laws of the U.S. corporation, the District of Columbia, the various state legislators, they voluntarily subject the people of the state to the federal process. But I'm going to hit you with something, brothers and sisters. There are two federal governments. You know what I told you, Steph? Seth? There's two federal governments, Seth. Two. You know what I told you? There's two federal governments. First is the United States of America that was formed by free men and free women. In other words, living souls. Operating under the Constitution, which was written for it. The other is the Incorporated United States, all capital letters, with no constitution. It only has bylaws. It only has rules. It has regulation. It has acts. It has statutes. It has codes. What? The Congress, the House of Representatives, and the United States Senate make up laws for both of these governments. Stop me where I'm lying at. But they have exclusive jurisdiction only over the United States, all capital letters, and not over the United States of America, lower you, by the way, or the individual that is in the sovereign state, the people. See, they could pass any legislation they wish pertaining to the United States, the corporation, but they must adhere to the Constitution when passing laws pertaining to the United States of America and the various sovereign states. See, if a law passed or is passed that is unconstitutional, it only applies to the people who live or were born or do business in the municipal United States. And it does not apply to I, man, if I am an American national of the United States of America. And there is a difference. They would make you believe that I'm crazy. And since you're in a box, you literally believe that. You say, oh man, that nigga go crazy. They said that about Yahusha also. See, but of course, not knowing any better, we presume that every law passed pertains to us. Wherever we live, work, whatever we do, we believe that it pertains to us. So we ignorantly, well, or as they say in the hood, ignorant. You're not ignorant. You're ignorant. They send a hurry, you think? So we ignorantly transverse into adhesion contracts. What does that mean? It's the legal term for connections, which change us from a free man of status to a man, or should I say, to a person under contract or agreement, into corporate beings, subject to whatever laws, rules, regulations, ordinances, statutes that the corporate government wish to place upon us. And some of these adhesion contracts are what? The birth certificate is an adhesion contract. The Social Security application is an adhesion contract. The DMV registration of vehicles are adhesion contracts. The driver's license is an adhesion contract. The voter's registration is a contract. The marriage license, yes, it is a contract. A business license, you want to do an LLC, S-Corp, that is a contract. See, in fact, the government has created a commercial straw man in legions, a liaison for each of us, so that we could operate in commerce as corporations. Yeah, I said it right, as a corporation. See, each of our straw men or corporation, which are actually what? Subject to their creator. Who are their creator? Government. You didn't create your straw man. So whenever you act from that capacity, you are under the authority. So why are you going into court arguing, fool? You're identifying as the corporate construct. Do you understand? Do you understand? The personal corporation they created for each of us, it has a name that sounds exactly like ours when you pronounce it. It's written in all capital letters, usually. Example, John Henry Doe, all capital letters. And I need you to remember, brothers and sisters, they can't reach or do business with us directly as man or woman, only indirectly, with a large portion of presumptions as the additional source of power. This is why they get so damn disappointed when you go in court and don't play by their games. Thumbs up as you come in the room. Let's get some donations up ahead. By the way, if you haven't registered for the up-and-coming webinar, it's going to take place on September the 2nd from 12 noon to 6 p.m. Do it now. Do it now. The link's in the room. Huh? And again, if you haven't tendered a donation, then do that now. It's the appropriate thing to do. Put the link in the room again so you don't ask me a question or toes of the how do we donate? As I was stating, despite the adhesion contracts, we are still sovereign over agencies which we created. And it's evident by California government code section 11120 and 54950. Both state, important part, the people of this state do not yield their sovereignty to the agencies which serve them. End of quote. So the federal constitution and that of our state affirmed the same day. It's true in every state, brothers and sisters. See, we individually and corporately are sovereigns over government agencies of whatever kind or make, right? Except that of many agencies that are not registered with the Secretary of State to do business in the state and exist as unincorporated. They exist as unincorporated associations that can't be sued. See, let me give you an example. For example, in Oregon, well, the state police are not registered corporations. In Oregon, the state police are not registered corporations. Huh? And I would well advise you to check the agencies of your own state. So the answer to the question, who are you, that I asked at the beginning of the video the other day, who are you? It should be clear that you are a man or an aggrieved man in a sovereign capacity. If you're a secure party creditor already, if you're not, what are you waiting for? Because then you will be the sovereign that has the liberty to enter into contract. See, the issue of commerce and contract is where the traps and the snares wait for you, brothers and sisters. But contrary to what you may have always thought, that changes everything. Huh? That changes everything. Again, I'm not an attorney. Nor am I trying to be one. Like it or not, if you're not a secure party creditor, you're a slave. If you got the wrong person to do your paperwork, you're a slave. If you have papers on file and you still haven't become debt-free, you're a slave. You're owned by the government. I need you to hear me well. If you don't listen to anything that I said thus far, stop doing what you're doing to listen. You are owned by the government. See, brothers and sisters, in 1921, the Federal Shepherd-Turner Maternity Act created the birth registration. The birth registration. You know what today is, the birth certificate. It was known as the Maternity Act. And it was sold to the American people as a law that would literally reduce maternal and infant mortality and to protect the health of the mothers and infants and to accomplish other purposes. See, one of those other purposes was to provide the state agencies in overseeing its operations and expenditures. What it really did was create a federal birth registry, which exists today. And that literally creates federal children. The government of parens patri. So now legislate for American children. And if they're owned by the federal or the state government, then you have no say in the matter. Now, through the public school enrollment process, right? I mean, you enroll your children for school. Through that public school enrollment process and continuing license requirement for most aspects of your daily life, the children grow up to be adults, indoctrinated into those things necessarily to, that's necessary to carry out activities that exist in what is called a free country. I dare you to disprove what I'm saying is wrong. Prior to 1921, the record of births and names of children were entered into the family Bible. Huh? See that big Bible behind me? Can you guys see that? So it's way up there. You can't see it. But it has a place in it for the names and all. There's a place in it for the names. Births and all of that. That's where they would store that. Before 1921. Since 1921, the American people have been registering the births of your babies. You've been registering the births and names of children with the government of the county and the state in which they were born. And I'm going to hit you with something. Even though there is no law requiring that, the state tells you that registration or registering your child's birth through the birth certificate serves as proof that he or she is born in the United States. What is that doing? Thereby making him or her a United States citizen. And for the past several years, a Social Security number was actually mandated to be issued at birth by the federal government. The Social Security number is one of those other purposes that I was speaking about, right? Why? Because it serves as a means of lifelong tracking of the one whose name is on the birth certificate. Do you understand? Do you understand? So on August the 9th, 1933, the United States, which is the corporate government, by the way, was declared bankrupt by President Roosevelt. The governors of the 48 states pledged the full faith and credit of each of their states, including the citizenry, as collateral. So it made you, the people, a collateral for debts that you had nothing to do with. Pledge you for the loans of credit from the privately owned Federal Reserve Bank. Full faith and credit. Go look up full faith and credit in Black Lewis Dictionary. Go look it up. I cannot make this up. See, after receiving the information of the live birth and other particulars for the birth certificate accompanied by the assigned Social Security number, the state literally claims an interest in the child, in fact, every child within its jurisdiction. So the state will, if it deems it necessary, to nullify your parental right and appoint a guardian, which is a trustee, right? That's a foster parent, huh? Over what you thought was your child. Come on, it happens every day in court. Stop me where I'm lying at. See, the subject of every birth certificate is a child. That's the subject. The child is a valuable asset that if properly trained can contribute valuable aspects provided by its labor for many years. So it is presumed by those who actually have researched what I'm talking about right here, well, that the Social Security number is the numbering registration of the trust, allowing for the trust assets to be tracked. So our children are owned by the state. Each one of us, including our children, is considered an asset of the bankrupt United States corporation. We are now designated by the government as human resources. So you go down and you ask for a job or a just over broke, where do you go to apply? Human Resources Department. Why? Because you are a human resource. You were born in a delivery room, delivered to the state of birth by way of the birth certificate, for which our informer, which is the mom, right, the mother, provides the requested information, including the name and the social security, which is really a tracking number, right? Well, with the bankrupt government, it's applied with a new court of collateral born each year. After being born free men and free women, our parents inadvertently turned us over to the state. How do they do that? By recording a birth certificate with the county in which we were born. So we're then chattel. And our lifetime production is to be used against the bankruptcy of the incorporated municipal United States. The certificate is sent to the Department of Commerce, where the government keeps a track of its property and is credited to the privately owned Federal Reserve Bank, which is not federal and it has no reserves and is not a bank, but a privately owned by 12 unambiguous wealthy families. Brothers and sisters, your birth certificate is valued at $1 million at birth, which is why the government has decided on average that each man or woman will produce during their lifetime and is used by the government as collateral to borrow the money for various purposes. So the birth certificate, in effect, says to the government, oh, master, here's another slave for you to work on your plantation. The parents being slaves themselves do not own their children. The government, which are the old masters, right, owns them, for it was he who gave the parents permission to marry, which is what? A marriage license. And if the parents do not take care of their children and treat them properly, the state social service will take them away and place them elsewhere, wherever they wish, a foster home. Do you understand? So, brothers and sisters, with that, I think I'm going to stop.